Hey everybody, it's Amy Astro here, and I am at the Bradley Observatory, which is on Agnes Scott College campus. And today I am the guest speaker. But you guys don't care about that. What you really want to know is what's inside this building. Well, hang tight and I'm going to show you what's inside. So what are you here? Are you the, what's your title?
I am the interim director of the Bradley Observatory. I'm filling in for Dr. Chris Dupree, who is on leave at the National Radio Astronomy Observatory.
Oh, cool.
In West Virginia. His expertise is radio telescopes, and I've been working with Chris off and on for about 20 years, so I told him I'd hold the fort down for the open houses and whatever else needs to be done.
Well, that's great, and you're doing one heck of a job, and as some of you guys may recognize, this is Ed Alvin, who is also an owner out at Deer Lick Astronomy Village, and if you remember about last year this time, I was showing you his observatory. So, can you show us what's inside?
We can. What we'll do is we'll take a look at the 30-inch Beck Telescope.
30-inch?
It's a big telescope right here in the city of Decatur. And also our what we call our mini Zeiss Planetarium. So lots of cool stuff tonight.
All right, so let's go inside.
All right.
Let's
see if it's open.
That's good they didn't lock you out.
Yeah, it stays locked most of the day.
All right, so we're inside the Bradley Observatory.
Let me show you the plaque here. The founding astronomer for the Bradley Observatory was William Calder, and he was here for about 25 years. And he was a beloved professor of astronomy and coordinated the building of the observatory, including the telescope that I'm going to show you upstairs. So
oh, great.
Follow me. Okay, and we have our, as we, this is good timing.
Yeah,
Amy Astro's, look at the moon through the
sky. Hi, everybody.
Oh, it's too late.
Oh, look.
We have our.
It's the moon.
Agnes Scott, astronomy students.
You guys don't mind being on camera?
Sure. Yeah,
all right. We'll see you guys on YouTube shortly.
Oh, yeah.
And they are operating the observatory for open house.
Well, thank you so much.
No problem.
This is great.
Wow.
So what we have here, I can point out, the 30-inch Beck telescope. And you can see the mirror through the cell. This mirror is about 2.5 feet across. It's like a giant eyeball.
Oh, wow.
2.5 feet across. And our astronomy students are configuring. It looks like they're going for either Jupiter or Saturn tonight. This telescope actually was constructed back in the 1930s and came up for sale in the late 1940s and was purchased by Agnes Scott. So it's been sitting on this pier ever since, more or less. There is a little story about we took it out to a deep sky site. But take a look at this. This is pretty cool. We have it's like a ship's captain's wheel that once we unlock it, you can actually turn the telescope.
Oh, nice.
With this wheel. It's there mostly for show. We control everything with a computer now.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to rain or anything, so if you wanted to just let it cool down, it should be fine.
Just leave it open?
Yeah, I'd say leave it open. There's no chance of rain.
I will take your word for it. Yeah. Beersburg.
And in it, were you able to put in another eyepiece, a better eyepiece?
Oh, I am not.
Should we try to switch that out?
I might, but Dr. Neville said it was going to be difficult.
Let me see. That looks like a 2-inch eyepiece.
Now look at this. On this big beast, you have a Telrad. I mean, wow.
That is one of the most important pieces of equipment.
That was the best line I ever made.
We're here standing on the platform surrounding the observatory, and we have a great view of our plaza downstairs, the entrance into the observatory. And you can immediately see what looks like a spiral. That represents the spiral of our Milky Way galaxy. And students, typically lab students, will set up their telescopes on this plaza at night. And we, here's something that everybody will love. We have a switch so we can turn off all the street lights and surrounding lights here, so it is pretty dark, even
and
though.
How much did that switch cost you? Because I could use one of those.
It's the secret switch.
The secret switch that turns off Atlanta, right?
Yes. Gives us dark skies. I wish it would turn off Atlanta, because the sky glow to the west here is pretty bright. We're east of Atlanta. But we have a beautiful night tonight with the waxing crescent moon and Venus.
Yes.
And down here on the plaza, I wanted to mention that you can see the orientation north, south, east, and west of the square. It's sort of like a rose compass. And then surrounding it, we have the planets drawn to scale. You can see the big round one, Jupiter. There's Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. And then the inner planets, the much smaller planets down here.
Nice.
Mercury.
Well, after we toured the telescope upstairs, we went downstairs to the planetarium itself, where we got to see their Zeiss Skymaster planetarium. And Ed was able to show me the planets and everything we were going to see in the sky tonight. And unfortunately, the camera wasn't able to pick up. It wasn't sensitive enough to show you the actual star show, but it was really something special. I thoroughly enjoyed my time at Agnes Scott College, and the students that I met there were truly fantastic, and I now have hope for our future and the stars. So guys, I hope you enjoy this video. Give me a big thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, and I wish you guys some great health, clear skies, and I will see you all in the next video. I love each and every one of y'all. Goodbye. We'll be right back.